Can you imagine standing here and having a 22-foot wall of water coming towards you in the wee hours of the morning before daylight, just rushing and roaring, just with all sorts of debris, just driving debris towards you? We can't live through this and not use this to help someone else down the line. We can't. It would be a waste of a hurt. And we all know God never wastes a hurt.
I really didn't know what to expect when I got down there, and I couldn't believe that it was still so bad down there. I can't imagine what it looked like when the hurricane first happened. Really touched my heart, you know, to see all those poor people and they were living in trailers and there was debris everywhere and their houses were in other people's yards, and it was just really sad. I felt really bad for them.
Realizing that those people had nothing and then just going there and seeing people, their homes were destroyed and people's belongings were scattered all over the yards, and I was picking them up and picking up people's memories, and it was pretty intense because I just had a moment where I kind of popped myself back to home and what would happen if I walked out of my hometown and it was all gone and there are pieces of my house 5 miles down the road.
It was really cool to see how just a small group of 12 people could go in and affect the people, not only the people that we're helping to clean up, but also bless the Christians there and just give encouragement back to them because they're living this reality every day.
I went there a few months ago and all this stuff needed to be done, and I'm kind of impressed by how much the community has done just by what little they have, but I'm also kind of upset about how much help they need and how little help they're getting. I mean, yeah, there was a bunch of churches and we've gone and other people go, but it just really surprises me that not more people want to help, because I mean, it's a great place and I wish I could do more.
I was just impressed with how people there in Oak Island didn't take this situation as an opportunity to wallow in self-pity and their own devastations. They're living there. They're rebuilding from the ground up if they have to, and that's what impressed me the most, just to see how they took what was a devastating situation that God threw at them, but took it and made it good.
There's a joy in helping people out and answering God's calling to helping the needy and helping those in need, helping the widows and the orphans, but I mean, not just those people in particular, but everybody that's in need, and showing the love of God through what we can do.
I never knew the depth of the Christian community and the sincerity of the Christian community until I saw it in action. You guys showed up right away and you continue to support us with resources when you can put them together. And it's not all about money. The hurt of the people will not go away with the money. It's people caring.